I remember almost 20 years ago, we were giving an award to a vice president from a very, very large company who just did significant work in the remanufacturing area. And the award basically looked into the waste that was diverted from going to landfill. We're looking into the energy conservation that the remanufacturing operation resulted in. And we're also looking at emission and many other environmental factors that we calculated, and we were providing this company with this award for that significant work they did by lowering their footprint through remanufacturing. And the vice president actually who accepted the award, when he stood up there to say a few words, he said, "I'm embarrassed." He said, "It's wonderful that we actually did all of this." He said, "But we honestly did it for the money." It was economically a great value for the company. It provided our customer with great value. We were able to provide our customer with product that lower costs, and that's why their demand was lower cost. And he said, as a business person, we did the right thing from a business point of view, but we're happy that it is actually having all of that impact environmentally. There are companies that are new to remanufacturing, and the value proposition for these companies is that it provides a significant ability for the company to have that closed loop system. When you remanufacture the product and the product comes back to you as a manufacturer of the product, you'll learn a lot more about what worked well, what didn't work well in the design of that product. Many times we over design systems, and maybe you put a lot of money into something that we can optimize it that would be maybe cost less. We also learn about things that degrade faster than we thought. But if you don't really have that closed loop system, it's very difficult to learn from the performance of the product, your old product, to help advise or guide the new design. The other factor also is that I think we're moving more and more into a challenge in terms of our material consumption in the manufacturing process, and the fact that you have a way to bring this product back and recycle material that might help offset your material cost in a very positive way. The third parameter here is that by actually bringing the product back, you are making sure that your product is handled properly at the end of life. You're able to ensure that this is done in a very proper way versus, if you weren't involved in that remanufacturing at all. And also we see some very new ways of actually from remanufacturing to realize significant value for the companies as well. So, many times as companies required to have spare parts for product for a long period of time, for durable product, for example, when the product in the market, the percentage of the product in the market is low, it's much easier and cheaper to actually use remanufacture component for the service and repair than it is to make them brand new. So the economics can be far more efficient if it's done this way.